Dear friends and colleagues, welcome to the cardiovascular session in the 2022 ACPM meeting, which is held in Irkutsk, a Russian city near Lake Baikal. It's my pleasure to speak with you in this meeting. My name is Farid Belialov. I am a professor of the Department of Geriatrics and Pharmacology in the Russian Medical Academy of Continuous Education. Because of travel restriction in different countries, our meeting will be virtual, and we invite colleagues to join our session. Today's meeting, we will be talking about mechanism, diagnosis, and treatment of comorbid cardiovascular diseases and mental disorders. It's my presentation. The title of my presentation is Optimization of Psychological Distress Treatment Using FOCAM Classification. Drug selection in presence of multimorbidity is a difficult task for physicians. The long lists of contraindications, warning, and precautions in drug instruction, short section and guidelines are inconvenient for practice when physicians must quick select optimal drugs for patients with comorbidity. Let's take a look at a few popular drug classification. The 40 list combines positive and negative labeling as A, B, C, D of drugs chronically prescribed to all the patients. The 40 classification has been proposed for reducing polypharmacy in elderly multimorbid patients. 40 list updated every 1 or 3 years. Now we use 2021 version. The next popular FDA classification divides drugs into classes A, B, C, D, and X, depending on the risk to the fetus and newborn. FDA not supported this classification from 2015, but its modifications are used until now in a few countries. There is a Center for Education and Research in Therapeutics maintains the drug list that have a risk of QT prolongation and cardiac arrhythmias. This classification divides drug into groups with conditional, possible, known, and high risk of malignant arrhythmias. As you know, sudden death is real when QT interval is longer than 500 milliseconds. And now you see FOCAM classification is a universal drug classification system based on effects of different drugs on comorbidities. FOCAM is abbreviation of fit for comorbidity. FOCAM classification unites the above mentioned systems and divides drugs into five classes based on their influence on comorbidities. Class A includes drugs that have pronounced positive effect on comorbid disease. Class B includes drugs that may have a mild positive effects. Class C includes drugs without any significant effect on contradictory effects. Class D consists of drugs with rare non-severe adverse effects. And class X includes drugs with severe life-threatening adverse effects. Here you see a 12th edition of book with FOCAM classification. It is published in this year in Russia. Here is example of classification of psychotropic drugs in comorbid mental disorders and somatic diseases. For example, valproic acid is approved for migraine prevention. On other hand, antipsychotic increase risk of sudden death, especially in patients with heart failure. Among patients with depression following recent acute coronary syndrome, treatment with escitalopram compared with placebo resulted in a lower risk of major adverse cardiac events after 8 years. Also, a positive effect of drug is shown in a randomized trial. The number of patients was small, only 300 people. Therefore, in order to classify escitalopram in class B or A, the results must be confirmed in large randomized trial. This meta-analysis presents the comparative effects of 32 oral antipsychotics on the acute interval. But how to use this information in practice? It's very inconvenient. And we presented modified algorithm for lowering the risk of cardiac arrhythmia during treatment with psychotropic medications. The original algorithm on the left side, and we consider that modified algorithm is more simple and more practical. Many drugs can significantly increase QT intervals, the risk of malignant ventricular arrhythmias and sudden cardiac death. Here the classification divides antidepressants, benzodiazepines and antipsychotics according its influence on QT interval. In order to quickly select optimal drugs in patients with comorbid diseases, this classification was introduced in CardiExpert 2 version, a well-known program for mobile devices on Android. This program is available on Google Play and is used in many countries. So, FOCOM classification unify existence narrow classifications, simplifies information from guidelines, and helps to select optimal drugs for patients with comorbidity. We regret that Congress participants didn't visit Lake Baikal, but we hope for future meetings in Baikal. A seal lie on a stone near 100 meters away from me, and I hid behind the large stone and shot seal, a recent photo from Baikal. Thank you for attention. Any question? Thank you very much, and we go on.